lice and birds from eating the wool of the sheep. And sometimes these lice will enter through the ear of the sheep and therefore enter into the brain and kill the sheep. So what they do is they rub the entire sheep, the wool, with olive oil to make these lice and the birds not to be able to enter and penetrate the sheep. This rubbing is what we call anointing. Exactly what God is about to do in your life. Amen. He wants to rub you with his nature. Amen. So that when you are rubbed, you are protected. Amen. And not only that you are protected, if there is any element of evil one, any element, any sign of yoke, by the presence of God in your life and by the direction this word of God is going, because it is a prophecy of what God wants to do, every yoke shall be destroyed. Amen. Even the meaning of the name Christ means anointed, anointed one, somebody who has been robbed by the nature of God. Somebody that is synonymous with God. Somebody that is the same with God. Somebody anointed. Somebody consecrated. So what the anointing does is that not only anoints you, but consecrates you for a particular function. And as he's doing that, he's breaking every yoke that is attached to you. Spiritual yoke from the devil. The anointing, we break it. Stand up and shout amen. Verse 4 says, today the yoke laid upon you has been broken. Yeah. And John 11:44 says, unbind him, let him go. Yeah. Today, by the power of the Holy Ghost, God will unchain and unbind you in the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Stand up, everybody. Hold your neighbor's hand. Just spread your two hands. Make sure nobody's sitting down. You are sitting down. Anointing breaks the yoke. The name Jesus himself, Christ, means anointing, which means by Christ the yoke shall be broken. Amen. And by the anointing as well, the yoke shall be broken. Let us see and reflect the power of the anointing. When you see Jesus Christ, after death, he was put in the tomb. And Matthew chapter 27 verse 66 says, a seal was placed on the tomb of Jesus Christ. Which means, it's as if they used concrete and rod and tied and chained the tomb of Jesus Christ. This man said he will rise again on the third day. Let us watch, put soldiers to watch and see how he will break this seal. And even if he succeeds, these soldiers will kill him. They were watching the only tomb that was ever watched. And there, when the anointing came on the Easter morning, the tomb was shattered. It was obliterated, it was destroyed by the anointing. Exactly what God is going to do in your family. What God is going to do in your situation. Only if you believe. Believe the word of God. 2 Chronicles chapter 20 verse 20. You shall prosper. Believe the word of my prophet and you shall be established. Amen. Yeah. Another example of what the anointing could do is a simple story of what we know in the scriptures. Acts of the Apostles chapter 16 verse 16. Paul and Silas were chained in the prison and they were yoked. They were unchained on their hands, on their leg, on their neck with other prisoners. They were singing, invoking the name of God, and God descended yoke we are broken was shattered into pieces. The Bible says, Christ Jesus, the same yesterday, today, and forever. If he did it for Paul and Silas, if he did it yesterday, if he did it in the past, he will do it again. Because he's still the same God. God forevermore. One God. He says, Matthew chapter 3, verse 6, I am the Lord God, I changeth not. And the Bible says in Exodus chapter 3, I am who am. I am what I am. I am I the Son of Man in Numbers 23:19 that I should lie? If I say I'm going to obliterate and shatter your yokes, I'm going to do it in the name of Jesus Christ. By the anointing. That same anointing. When Samson was chained in the temple of Dagon, the god of the Philistines, his two eyes have been plucked off. The power in his hands, the hands have been shaved off. Samson stood behind two pillars in chains, in yoke. Yoke on his leg, yoke on his hands. And he held the two pillars and prayed, God, just for one more chance. God, for one more chance. Restore my strength, O Lord. Lord, give me your strength again. God, make your name known in the land of the heathen, in the land of the Philistines, that there is no other God beside thee, that at your name every knee must bow, that your God in heaven, God on earth, that your God everywhere, that God, give me my strength once more. Even though I have sinned, and the strength, the anointing came. Anointing is the power of God in you. When the power is in you, when the power is in you, God will be the person walking in you. No longer you that you know, but the God will be inside you. God will be inside you, Emmanuel. Will be inside you speaking. Will be inside you fighting. Will be inside you delivering. Will be inside you. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. Power of God, the anointing. And when the anointing came on Samson, he no longer Samson, ordinary Samson, but God in him walking. He pushed, and the entire upstairs, the entire church, the entire temple of the evil spirit fell. And the Bible said, the most interesting aspect, Samson killed 3,000 people. He killed more people in his death than in his life. What the anointing can do. That's why Jesus told his disciples, preach not for me. Heal no sick person for me. Do no miracle for me. But stay in Jerusalem until I fill you with the anointing. Anointing of the Holy Ghost. And when the Spirit came, these apostles were like wild dogs let loose. The world, the church was afraid of the world before now. But when the anointing came, the world became afraid of the church. Peter could now boldly come out and speak. Because it's no longer Peter, you know. Peter who even could not speak before a slave girl. Now this Peter came in the temple at Jerusalem and converted 3,000 people at a single sermon he preached. Because it's no longer by power or by might, but by the Spirit of God at work in Peter. And Philip went to Samaria under the power of the anointing, and there were deliverances, there were healing, there were miracles, because it's no longer Stephen, it's no longer Philip, but the power of God at work in him. For this anointing to come, hold your neighbor. For this anointing, you have to dispose yourself. As I'm hearing the sound of this word, God, please, send your anointing unto me. God, please, break the yoke that is laid upon me, as well as the rest of the members of my family. As you are stepping out of this arena tonight, or this morning, your situation can never be the same again. Because the Spirit of God will be at work in you. The Spirit of God will redo what the enemy comes to. A witch today, But Jesus did the first Pentecost before the second Pentecost. Because after resurrecting from the dead, he went to the disciples and breathed unto them the Holy Spirit. So what God is doing tonight is breathing unto you Goliath and the Philistines. Another time, when the Philistines were a yoke on the neck of the Israelites, God sent Samson. And he fought, not by his own power or might, but by the anointing. When the Israelites were under yoke and bondage in Egypt, God sent Moses and anointed him to fight Pharaoh with the entire host of the Egyptian army. By the anointing, the sea was parted in two. Power in the anointing. Can you raise your two hands up? Any yoke of the devil, any yoke of the ancestors, any yoke. Sometimes you do certain things you do not know when you did. And after crying, you redo again. Because of a yoke that is placed upon you. And this night, this morning, this bad and ugly situation have come to end in the name of Jesus Christ. Because by the anointing, and the anointing will come, the anointing is already in the word. And it shall break every yoke. So begin to dispose yourself. Begin to open up yourself so that any yoke inherited or placed upon you will be broken. So that you go back a new person. The Spirit of God is at work. The Spirit is moving to break every yoke in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Close your hands up. Close your eyes. Invite the anointing of God. Sometimes particular people, you are just always the best person experiencing scars all over you. Wake up every morning, you have scars all over your body. You complain of witchcraft because the anointing has not found place in you. Open up yourself for the anointing of the Holy Ghost to take over. Various spirits possess you. Every night, you are in the spirit world, dancing with strangers, dining with strangers, moving with strangers, moving with mermaids. You are made queen here and there. You are under yoke.